Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the University Albany Great Danes and the Harvard Crimson. Here are two players who will need to help carry the load for their teams today. And of course, our starting lineup.
No matter the game, your starting five must be ready to play. As soon as the ball is tossed up, you gotta be ready. Too many teams fall behind early because they are just not ready to perform.
When we get going here today, these will be the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long. So here we go. In the post. Harper is definitely a blue-collar type of player, not afraid to get his hands dirty.
You gotta have guys like this on your team, Gus, and you gotta love him. An unselfish player who does everything you ask him to do.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. He missed it.
Dominating the glass.
Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. They work the perimeter. Fire!
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
Shots up, and he can't get the bounce. Crawford receives the pass. In the lane. Shots off.
He owns the window.
Watkins handles the feed. The fans are making a difference, Rap. Count the points. That's goaltending. And another look at that dunk.
Filling the lane and providing the lift.
On the left side. Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson, and joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Rafter. Off the mark, Dyer receives the ball. He got it up and in. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Get out and fill.
Shots there if he wants it. Fires. Shots off.
Way to get up, big fella.
Kenzie on the move. Inside. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a bit easier.
This kid really does a good job of reading the D and seeing the whole floor. And he loves to give it up. He really does a good job of scoring as well.
Kenzie handles the pass.
Elevation!
You've got to be prepared when you go up against this team, Raph. Their pressure can be relentless at times. They love to pressure you full court.
Well, you're right on top of that, Gus. They really like to force you into mistakes with their pressure.
In the lane. Shots off.
What a rebound. I own it.
Looking for a good shot. In the lane. No. Pulls it in.
English on it.
On the inside. Can finish. out on the left wing. He shoots from outside. Top of the key. He shoots from the left of the circle.
How about that, Gus?
The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
On the wing. And he's fouled. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just gotta know when to back off.
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key to any successful program.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
He got them both. Danes are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Loose ball save. The ball stripped. On the wing. Jump shot. He missed it.
See, reacting. How alert, Gus.
That's charging.
A classic case of a player trying to do too much, Gus. He forced the issue there.
Now they work it around the perimeter. And he lays it up and in. On the right side. It's a call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
How you always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Gus, without a doubt, this will be an emotional year for him, but the key is to stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time to reflect at the end of the season. His team needs him to perform at his best now.
No good.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
Way out on the right wing. In the lane. The sophomore, Douglas, is described as being one of those powerful inside players.
He's strong, and he knows how to use his strength, Gus. When he catches it down the box, he's just such a force.
Looking for a good shot. Watch out. Bang. Great Danes are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Rath.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
And in. They work the perimeter. Great Danes look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
Well, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel, Gus. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
The Great Danes are looking real good out there, really working together.
If you keep working together and running this motion offense, they'll be in position to win.
Shots off. Grabs the rebound. On the right side. In the lane. And he answers. A great job of moving the ball, Coach.
Gus, when you move the ball like that, you force the D to react, and which in turn is the offense the upper hand.
The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
Heat check time from long range. Out on the right wing. He shoots from the corner. The sophomore. The Great Danes are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Pass in the paint. Second team foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Two shots. Makes it. We have a pause of the action. More NCAA basketball coverage in a moment. Back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. They work it around the perimeter. Up and in. Ha We are at the 7-minute mark. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Free throw shooting isn't his forte, but every now and then we'll see him make a couple.
Just got to get into a routine. It's about routine and repetition.
Gets two at the charity stripe. Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane, and he can't get the ball.
What a rebound! It's mine.
On the low block, he fires away. Off the mark.
Transition.
the wing.
Fire! Got it!
Wow! This guy is a complete player in the post.
He really causes problems, Gus, for the D. You have to double him, and that creates havoc on others.
Dump it inside.
And lays it in.
We are at the six-minute mark. The Great Danes are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full-court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Ah, he got it up and in. The Great Danes have controlled the tempo here.
Gotta love the way they've come out here and really focused on their game plan. They've done a good job making sure the game is being played at their pace.
Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane, the junior. The Great Danes are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
In the post. In the lane. We're at the 5-minute mark. Making a name for himself, he's really stepping up his performance. May have him right where they want him, Raph. It's stripped. Active hands. The Great Danes in a hurry. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Push it.
Out on the left wing. Shots off.
It's mine.
Work it around the perimeter. We're at the 4-minute mark. Entry pass in the paint.
Inside.
A great trap initiated by the defense.
Fires.
No.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arms.
Turns it over. Now looking to attack.
Put a little English on it.
Now, he's a pure shooter. You can't give him any space.
If he can catch it in rhythm and get a clean look, you can put it in the bank. He knocks him down.
On the left side. Turnover. He'll want that one back. They've worked the perimeter. Three minutes left on the game clock. He missed it. Pulls it down. Can finish. On the outside. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. Inside, power jam. The Great Danes seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Let's go back and see this one from a different angle.
When you finish like this, you don't have to worry about getting your shot blocked.
Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. On the left side, in the lane, shots off.
Get out and fill.
on the outside. Fires the senior. On the left side. Jump shot. Nice touch there to use the back door. The Great Danes look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
Well, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel, Gus. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Off the mark.
And he looks to outlet.
Pushes it. One minute left on the game clock. Nice pass to the low block. Great defensive positioning.
Understands the game.
Right wing. With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Lobs it. On the right side. In the lane. Shots off.
Look to outlet.
Dials up a long range shot. And hits. Up next, the road to the Final Four. Please stay tuned. Here is our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who has been doing what.
We can see here how both teams are doing with the keys they identified at the outset.
Gus, it looks like they're going with the minimum.
On the left side. And he lays it up and in.
How about that back cut, Gus? These kids can play a little bit. Terrific delivery.
They work it around the perimeter. And he bangs it down. Pushes it. They may have him in some trouble here.
What a great trap, Gus. The defense is getting after it.
Do they need a timeout here, Ryan?
Gus, they definitely need a timeout. They've lost their composure.
The Great Danes are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal, but they can't play the full court game.
Right way. Fires. Shots off. What a rebound. And we'll get a change of possession. They're going to call that a backcourt violation.
You've got to think. You've got to limit those moments.
On the baseline. Up and in. Ha ha! the outside. In the lane. And he gets it. The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
Looking for a good shot. He can't get it to go.
I own it.
In the post. Jump shot. No. Harper keeps it alive.
Total control. Knows where to be. Location. A high rent district.
The Great Danes look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
While pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel cost. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
They work it around the perimeter. He missed it.
Great strength.
On the left side. Shots up. Rims off.
A good defensive possession will always end in a defensive rebound.
On the low block. In the lane.
Big time dagger.
The Great Danes are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Raph.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
First personal foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You've really got to know your limitations, Gus.
With the pair. He misses it. Rims off. Snatches the rebound. On the right side. Fired. Shots off. Pulls down the rebound. Out on the left wing. And lays it in. On the wing. Got it up and in. Cut back door and receive the pass.
Boy, well-timed backdoor cuts. They're just pretty to watch, Gus. Not to mention the finish.
And it goes in. Tup it inside. Jump shot. Shots off. Snatches it down. On the left side. Fires. Shots off. Grabs the rebound. Out on the left wing. Jump shot.
How about that? Huh?
The Great Danes are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Fired. Shots off.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
On the wing. Nice. Stewart gets the pass. Jump shot. Shots off.
Rebound and run.
dump it inside.
Inside.
On the outside. Fire. Shots off.
Nice rebound.
Dyer receives the pass. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce.
Put a little English on it.
Kenzie handles the feed. Off the mark.
You always want to limit the opposition to just one shot, Gus.
Watkins receives the ball. Can finish. Harper handles the pass. He strokes it. Coach, these guys are really struggling here tonight.
Having a tough time finding the goal. Not a great performance here tonight, Gus.
Looking for a good shot. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. And they burn a timeout. We'll have more NCAA basketball coverage in a moment. The Great Danes are out in front as we head into the timeout. Dump it inside. And he lays it up and in. This guy can light things up in a hurry. He's got a scorer's mentality.
Well, this kid gets into a groove and he can score a bunch of points in a very short period of time.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He can't get it to go.
Oh, physical play.
The Great Danes are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game, really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
Shots off. Pulls it down. Fired. No.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Dump it inside. It's a call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in. You get in trouble.
Here's another solid junior build.
Gus, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. And as a coach, you can rely on them for their experience and ability to guide the less experienced players on the team.
He got them both. down on the low block, trying to work it inside.
Perfect.
The Great Danes are playing their style and controlling the tempo.
You know, Gus, it's all about going out there and executing. They've done a great job of taking care of tempo.
Dump it inside. He missed it.
See the floor. You can get some easy, fast breaks.
Jump shot. And he can't get them out.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
Takes the medium-range jump shot. Off the mark.
Oh, physicality.
7 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. Watkin turns the ball over. On the left side. Up and in. Ha ha! The Great Danes look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
Well, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel, Gus. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
Way out on the right wing. With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Fires. 6 minutes left on the game. He gets the rejection. Out the basket. That's golden. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Coach.
As a coach, it's great to see all five guys on the floor working together. That is impressive. That's how you win, and win consistently, Gus. When multiple people contribute, it takes the pressure off your superstar.
On the left wing. He can't get it to go.
Get out and fill.
Out on the wing. Jump shot. He gets that one to fall. On the wing. In the lane.
How about this kid, huh?
The Great Danes are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
He doesn't get the hoop. On the outside. Fires. Gets it to go. The Great Danes are taking things to the next level with their extended pressure defense, Raph.
An aggressive move on their part, Gus. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
They work the perimeter. He nails the bucket. On the right side. He drains the bucket. 4 minutes left on the game clock. The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
He unloads the three. No luck from downtown. Pushing in transition. Great block shot. And lays it in. The Great Danes seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Now with the block. And the ball is out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
You gotta make those, Gus. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
Left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. He gets the shot to fall. Dump it inside. Uncharacteristic mistake there by the senior. On the right side. Fires. No!
Great inside control.
They work the perimeter. In the lane. He gets it to fall. The Great Danes are really looking to turn up the pressure and perhaps tempo with this press build.
It looks like they want the tempo to be faster. This change will likely increase the pace of play.
Crawford really distributes the basketball very well.
You know, he really is the extension of the guys on the sideline. Really a great leader on the floor.
Way out on the right wing. Jump shot. No. Gets the ball. They work it around the perimeter. Bounds and a change of possession. The Great Danes' ability to get scoring from their reserves has been key.
Not only can they rest the starters, but they can add to the lead.
A great trap initiated by the defense. He missed it.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
Around a minute remaining. They'll throw this one in from the side. Out on the right wing. Sideline inbound. Ball coming in from the sideline. Baseline inbound. The line. Hits that one. Makes the shot. On the left side. Ah, he got it up and in. One and the bonus.
Takes the pressure off.
He sinks it. work the perimeter. Heat check time from long range. And no! On the left side. Mark with the shot. While we have the time here, let's take a look at our players of the game.
These two young players here have stepped up for their teams, Gus. Pretty good performances.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for now. Tune in for more college basketball action on CBS Sports, brought to you by EA Sports. For Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson.